Well, all this week, we are taking you to northwestern part of our state for Arizona's family road trip. Now, when we go to northern Arizona, a lot of us head to Flagstaff or Sedona, maybe Prescott. But again, we are focused on this northwest part of our state, and we found some really unique sites to visit. So today, we're taking you to the farm, but this is probably a farm like you've never been to, a ranch, really, where you can get up close and personal with alpacas.
You can tell he loves these on his days off.
Their personalities are as unique as their haircuts and their coloring. But the herd at the Alpacas of the Southwest Ranch near Kingman is a gentle bunch.
This is a Teddy boy.
To Ron Nyberg, Teddy is like one of his kids, one of 40, at their family farm run by him and his wife, Anna.
We have a lot of fun naming the animals all after the Beatles. So we have Revolver, Hey Jude, Penny Lane, Michelle Mybelle, Lady Madonna. People will come and I'll tell them the different names and they go, how can you remember the names? It's like if you have a dozen children, you're gonna know Sally from Linda and from Pete.
The Nybergs love to share the family love. Anyone can stop by and tour the ranch. You can learn about the business side. The Nybergs say alpacas have a fleece that is hypoallergenic.
Besides being very, very soft, it's as warm as wool. But it's a third the weight of wool. It's also very thermal. It has an insulating aspect of it, so you can actually wear the socks and different garments in the summer as well as in the winter. It keeps you warm in the winter and keeps you cool in the warmer climates.
In the shop, you can purchase a sweater or socks or other products made with alpaca fiber, but you can also learn about just how social alpacas are.
As a herd animal, it is extremely important for them to be happy with their friends, neighborhood, so to say, and they'll travel in little family groups. So every pen is going to have a I'm in charge, and it's also going to have the last guy in there that says, yeah, I'll follow along. Here, hold your hands out.
Okay.
Both hands.
The animals are gentle enough that you can feed them yourself and take pictures with them. Nyberg say the high desert of northwest Arizona is the perfect climate and environment for alpacas. So if you're on your way to Vegas, it's the perfect pit stop or a great destination as part of a day trip.
It's a time they can come and do something kind of fun before they get back on the road.
And if you visit the Nybergs and their family, you're sure to get a warm greeting and a smile.
And you know, Anna was talking about getting back on the roadway. I know you like the little picture that I pulled up here.
Great.
They are really sweet animals. And you know, when Anna talks about getting back on the road, I mean, they are literally right on the way to Las Vegas. So as you come up the 93, you know, you get on that 140. It's literally 5 miles past the 93. You just get off the freeway. Maybe you stretch your legs for about an hour and you get to play with the alpacas and then you're back on your way if you like. They really are gentle animals. And they say, you know, if you want a tour, it's probably best to call ahead because they'll customize your tour. So if it's a bunch of adults, they'll teach you a little bit more about the business side. Okay. If it's kids, they'll you know, make it a little bit more simple so the kids can play with the alpacas. But they're really sweet animals. They do have a range of personalities.
Uh-huh.
Some might be a little bit more ornery than more others, but for the most part, they are very gentle.
Just
animals.
Like us.
Yeah. And they are so soft to pet.
Yes,
love
they are.
Their fur.
Yeah, amazing. Their wool is just it. In fact, I got to tell you, I bought a pair of socks. They
yes.
are. Just so soft.
I bet they are.
What if faces? What if I don't want a tour? What if I want an alpaca?
Well, you could talk to them about it. I will tell you. So they've got 40, but they have 2 babies on the way.
Oh, there we go.
Yeah. I wonder where you get one. That's a good question. I don't have no idea where they come from.
You know, they did tell me, I don't know where they come from or where you get one either, but they did tell me that you can't purchase them like a horse, for example.
Okay.
So,
okay.
Yeah, but you just have to find somebody who.
I love these stories, Gina. Thank you.
They're so much fun.
Yeah, really great job.
And a road trip.
That is a
cute face.
By the way, we should mention, we're going to put all of the information from all of the different places we visit this week on our website. So I know a lot of folks get out of school next week.
Road trip. So if you're thinking, yes, exactly, or maybe in June, right, you're thinking,
where can we go? We'll have all the information there. We should mention, in that part of our state, the northwest part of our state, the high desert, it's about 15 degrees cooler than
us. That's right.
Yeah, that's true.
So they say, come on up.
Yeah.